Welcome back, everyone. I'm Dronetek. The Democrats are in serious trouble in 2022 and beyond. Now, this is something I already knew, but it was laid out very succinctly by a guy named MartyrMade on Twitter. He's got a podcast on MartyrMade.com. But he laid out a series of tweets giving a really good synopsis of why so many people distrust and hate the media and the Democrats as well. Now, a lot of this won't be new to any of you because it's what I talk about on this channel every day and have since it's been around. This guy's tweets really went viral, and I think he's on to something. I don't know if you all saw, but yesterday Rasmussen put out a poll that showed 58% of Americans now agree that the media is enemy of the people. That's significant, and there's really good reasons for all of that, which this guy lays out. And I wanted to just go through and read out his series of tweets because he makes some really good points, but I'll just start from the top here. I think I had discussions with enough boomer-tier Trump supporters who believe the 2020 election was fraudulent to extract a general theory about their perspective. It is also the perspective of most of the people at the Capitol on 1-6 and probably even Trump himself. Here are the facts, actual confirmed facts that shape their perspective. One, the FBI spied on the 2016 Trump campaign using evidence manufactured by the Clinton campaign. We now know that all involved knew it was fake from day one. And then he cites Brennan's July 2016 memo. These are Tea Party people, the types who give their kids a pocket constitution for their birthday and have founding father memes in their bios. The intel community spying on a presidential campaign using fake evidence, including forged documents, is a big deal to them. Not only that, but if you look into it now, if you go back and read, we know now that everything in that document was Russian disinformation. So what really happened there? What happened was the Russians gave Christopher Steele disinformation that he then gave to the government, and then the government gave to the media, and then they all disseminated it because they were so angry that they lost the 2016 election. So what did? They disseminated Russian disinformation as an attack on the president. Everyone involved lied about their involvement as long as they could, and that is true. We only learned about the DNC paying for the manufactured evidence because of a court order. Comey denied it on TV knowing the DNC paid for it when we have emails from a year earlier proving that he knew. This was true with everyone from CIA Director Brennan and Adam Schiff, who were on TV saying that they seen clear evidence of collusion with Russia. You remember they did that while there was none. While admitting under oath behind closed doors that they hadn't, all the way down the line. In the end, we learned that it was all fake. Absolutely, it was. The entire thing was essentially just to torpedo the Trump presidency. They did the same thing to George W. Bush, but you know, he played it a little more politically, like a politician would, whereas Trump was more of just kind of a regular guy, not a politician. At first, many Trump people were worried that there must be some collusion, because every media and intel agency wouldn't make it up for nothing. Although, I gotta tell you, I was skeptical, because like, I've been into this for 20 years, and I have not trusted the media for a long time, so I was a little skeptical. When it was clear that they had made it up, people expected a reckoning and shed many illusions about their government when it didn't happen. This is absolutely true. And this is kind of what the media has done to me and a lot of people. I mean, they just lie so blatantly. They get away with it. They lie right to our faces. They gaslight us. We know as a fact that the Steele dossier was the sole evidence used to justify spying on the Trump campaign. And B, the FBI knew the Steele dossier was a DNC op, as well as Russian disinformation. They knew that as well. Steele's source told the FBI that the info was unserious. They did not inform the court or any of this and kept spying. Right, and then they lied to get FISA warrants as well for spying. Trump supporters know the collusion case front and back. This is true. I get in so many arguments with people who think they know a lot about it, but they don't. You know, they didn't watch any of the hearings. They don't really know anything about it. All they know about is what they heard around the water cooler, or you know, what CNN told them. They don't really know much about it, and that's the way the media likes it. They went from worrying about the collusion must be real to suspecting it might be fake, to realizing it was a scam. Then watched as every institution, agencies, the press, Congress, academia, gaslit them for another year. Worse, collusion was used to scare people away from working in the administration. Exactly. It was an intimidation tactic to keep people from working with them then and in the future. They knew their entire lives would be investigated. Many quit before they were being bankrupt by legal fees. The DOJ, press, and government destroyed lives and actively subverted an elected admin. This is absolutely true. They really did the same thing during the Bush administration as well. It's hard to describe to people on the left who were used to thinking of government as a conspiracy, Watergate, WMD, etc., how shocking and disillusioning this was for people who encouraged their sons to enlist in the army and hate people who don't stand for the anthem. They could have managed this shock if it only involved the government, but the behavior of the corporate press is really what radicalized them. They hate journalists more than they hate any politician or government official because they feel most betrayed by them. And really, I think it's because we see that that's where the real power is. It's in the media. Those are the people who have the real power because they're the ones who are able to whip up the mobs that come and put pressure on the politicians or put pressure on corporations, businesses. And the fact that they're clearly in the tank for one party and one ideology and are trying to push out the other one, it makes them really seem like a major threat. I mean, they don't seem like a major threat. They absolutely are. They spend so much time talking about how we're a threat to democracy while they're trying to wipe out political opposition and have one-party rule that'll be propped up by a state media complex. The idea that press is driven by ratings and sensationalism became untenable. And yeah, this is in the early days of me debating with people about media bias. They would always say, oh, the media's not biased. They're just biased for ratings. And my comeback was always, well, if that's the case, then why aren't they all Fox News clones? Because Fox News was, you know, destroying all of them. And of course, they never had an answer for that. And the answer is because that's not what they're biased for. They're politically biased. If that were true, they'd be all over the Epstein story. The corporate press is the propaganda arm of the regime. They now see an outline. Nothing anyone says will ever make them unsee that, period. And this is absolutely on. This guy is just nailing it, this MartyrMade guy. This is profoundly disorienting. Many of them don't know for certain whether ballots were faked in November 2020, but they know for absolute certain the press, the FBI, etc. would lie to them if there was. They have every reason to believe that, and it's probably true. Exactly. I don't talk a lot about the election stuff because I just don't know. But, I mean, wouldn't it all surprise me? Because look at, like, just the long string. The coronavirus is kind of the same way. It's just this long string of attempts to torpedo the Trump presidency that started before he even took office. In early January, there were articles about impeaching him. And then, bam, man, as soon as he got on, that talking point began. And then the Steele dossier got injected. And then it was just like scheme after scheme after scheme. They watched the press behave like animals for 4 years. Tens of millions of people will always see Kavanaugh as a gang rapist based on nothing because of CNN. And you'll remember, during Kavanaugh's confirmation, Democrats by the hundreds stormed the Supreme Court and tried to stop the process of confirmation. The media now considers that insurrection. But back then, of course, they were considered heroes for doing that because they were carrying out the media's orders, essentially. And CNN seems proud of that. They led a lynch mob against high school kid. They cheered on summer riots. Yes, and you might remember my first interview video was actually at the Covington School when Antifa showed up there to protest them for a story that ended up being completely fake. The kids were painted as racist. It turned out the adults were all the racists. These two clearly racist groups that attacked these kids, but the media tried to make it out like the kids, the victims, were the actual aggressors. They always claimed that the media had a liberal bias. Fine, whatever. They still thought the press would admit the truth if they were cornered. Now they don't, and this is absolutely true. They won't. They'll just double down. It's a different thing to watch them invent stories whole cloth in order to destroy regular lives and spark mass violence. Time magazine told us during the 2020 riots that they were weekly conference calls involving, among others, leaders of the protest, the local officials who refused to stop them, and media people who framed them for political effect. In Ukraine, we call that a color revolution. Throughout the summer, Democrat governors took advantage of coronavirus to change voting procedures. Exactly. It wasn't just the mail-ins. They lowered the signature matching standards, etc. After the collusion scam, the fake impeachment, Trump people expected shenanigans by now. Exactly. You knew it was coming. The coronavirus lining up, the whole coronavirus thing lining up with the election. You could see it coming a million miles away. Re-fake impeachment. We now know that Trump's request for Ukraine to cooperate with the DOJ regarding Biden's activities in Ukraine was in support of active investigations being pursued by the FBI and Ukraine AG at the time. So a completely legitimate request. Right. So he was essentially, Trump was impeached. Both those impeachments were total shams. I mean, in the second impeachment, they had stuff in there that was just complete lies. That wasn't true at all. Then you get the Hunter Biden laptop scandals. Big Tech ran a full-on censorship campaign against a major newspaper to protect a political candidate, period. Everyone knows it. All the tech companies admit it was a mistake, but, you know, the election's over, so who cares? Yeah, and I've pointed out many times that these mistakes, they always call them mistakes, only ever cut one way. You will not find any of these mistakes occurring to Democrats or left-wingers. It just doesn't happen. It goes without saying, but if the New York Times had Don Jr.'s laptop full of pics of him smoking crack and engaging in group sex, lots of lurid family drama emails describing direct corruption and backed up by the CEO of a company they were using, the New York Times wouldn't have been banned. And we all know this. And this is exactly, he's exactly right. This is why we distrust and hate the media and these American institutions that have been taken over by them. Think back, stories about Trump being pissed on by Russian prostitutes and blackmailed by Putin were promoted as fact. And the only evidence was a document paid for by his opposition and disavowed by its source. The New York Post was banned for reporting on true information. The reaction of Trump people to all this was not, no fair. That's how they felt about Romney's binders full of women in 2012. This is different. Now they see correctly that every institution is captured by people who will use any means to exclude them from the political process. Absolutely. And this is, again, not to repeat myself, but I've been talking about this on my channel going back to the beginning. And yet they showed up in record numbers to vote. He got 13 million more votes than in 2016, 10 million more than Clinton got. As election night dragged on, they allowed themselves some hope, but when the four critical swing states and only those states went dark at midnight, they knew. Media and tech did everything to make it worse. Everything about the election was strange. The changes to procedure, unprecedented mail-in voting, the delays. But rather than admit and make everything transparent, they banned discussion of it. Everyone knows that. Just as Don Jr.'s laptop would have been the story of the century if everything about the election dispute was the same, except the parties were reversed. Suspicions about the outcome would have been taken very seriously. Exactly. I mean, he says see 2016 for proof, but I say go back to 2000. Look at what went with Bush. They said that that election was stolen. Then they said it again in 2004. They said it was stolen. And there was riots at the inaugural parade. And then Obama gets elected. Everything's perfect now. Oh, everything's great. Trump gets elected. Oh, the election was stolen again. So that's the pattern. That's how it works. Even the court's refusal of the case gets nowhere with them because of how the opposition embraced mass political violence. They'll say, with good reason, what judge would stick his neck out for Trump knowing he'll be destroyed in the media as a violent mob burns down his house? The state of affairs in America right now, folks. It's a fact. According to Time magazine, that mass riots were planned in cities across the country if Trump won. Sure, they were protests, but they were planned by the same people as during the summer, and everyone knows what that would have meant. Judges have families too. Forget the ballot conspiracies. It's a fact that governors use COVID to unconstitutionally alter election procedures. The Constitution states that only legislatures can do so. To help Biden to make up for a massive enthusiasm gap by gaming the mail-in ballot system. They knew it was unconstitutional. It's right there in plain English. But they knew the case wouldn't see court until after the election. And what judge would toss millions of ballots because a governor broke the rules? The threat of mass riots wasn't implied, it was direct. So our country is essentially being held hostage by violent communist mobs that are backed by our state media and one of the political parties. The entrenched bureaucracy and security state subverted Trump from day one. The press is part of the operation. Election rules were changed. Big tech censors opposition. Political violence is legitimized and encouraged. Trump is banned from social media. They were led down some rabbit holes, but they are absolutely right that their government is monopolized by a regime that believes they are beneath representation and will observe no limits to keep them from getting it. Trump fans should be happy he lost. It might have kept him alive. So that's it. A really good summary of why the people hate the media, why people now 58% of the country see the media as the enemy of the people. You really wonder, and I ask this question often in my videos, is do these people in the media, do they know what they are and what they're doing? Or are they really just like brainwashed people? Or do they really just lack self-awareness? I don't think it's that. I think that they know what they're doing. And they rationalize it in their heads what they're doing because they spend so much time demonizing all of us in the worst possible terms. And I warned you all about this forever ago that the left, what makes them particularly dangerous is they seem to just be able to rationalize anything. And when you start seeing the mass media constantly put out this drumbeat that their political opposition are racist, white supremacists, white nationalists, Nazis, domestic terrorists, I mean, they're one step away from just calling us subhumans. To these propagandists in the media, they're no doubt telling themselves that we're so horrible that anything that they have to do to save democracy is justified. When in reality, they're the ones who are enemies of the Constitution. They hate the Constitution. They hate America's history and want to tear it down. They hate the American flag and Mount Rushmore. These people don't like this country, they hate this country, and they want to turn it into something it was never meant to be. All right, folks, that's all I have for this one. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, please hit that like button on your way out and let me know what you think in the comment section.